Good day to all of you. Myself, Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dean of College, Bikaner. Today we are going to understand about the topic Ridley-Watkinson-Hilson theory. RWH theory. There are many explanations offered for the gun. We already understand about the gun effect, what is gun effect and how it is explained in the previous videos. In 1964, Cromer suggested that Gunn's observations were in complete agreement with the Ridley-Watkinson-Hilson theory. Cromer is a scientist and he suggests the Gunn's observation correlation with the RWH theory, Ridley-Watkinson-Hilson theory. Differential negative resistance. First of all, we know about what is differential negative resistance. The fundamental concept of the Ridley-Watkinson-Hilson theory is the differential negative resistance developed in a bulk solid state third to fifth group compound. Bulk solid state compound, and we are taking the compounds from third to fifth group in periodic table, and RWH theory is related with differential negative resistance in these specific compounds, whether either a voltage or electric field or a current is applied to the terminal of the sample. If we are taking a sample and we are applying voltage or electric field or current is applied across the terminal of the sample, there are two modes. There are two modes of negative resistance device. Here the concept is that negative resistance device have two modes. One is voltage controlled and second one is current controlled mode. Okay, and these are shown in figure A and B, 7.21A and 7.21B. First curve gives the concept of voltage controlled mode. If we increase the voltage, that is if we increase the electric field, then the variation of current density is shown in this curve. And we see that here current density can have multivalued, and the curve show initial is rise, then there is decrease, and after a minima there is again an increase. And in the second curve, current controlled mode, and by increasing E, what is the value of Z? Here we are showing the curve like such kind of curve. This is for current controlled. Okay, so let us start to understand voltage controlled mode. The current density can be multiplied. Where is the current controlled mode? The voltage can be multivariate. You can easily understand here, for voltage control mode, if we draw a line from here, if I see this strip, here you can see, you just draw a line. And at the, we see that current density have multivariate. This one, and this one. In this case for voltage. And for current controlled mode, if we draw a line like that, we see that for current controlled mode, voltage can be multivariate. This is voltage E. And this is current density. The major effect of the appearance of a differential negative resistance region in the current density field curve is to render the sample electrically unstable. What is the meaning of negative resistance? If by increasing E, J decreases, then this part shows the negative resistance. And this part shows positive resistance. And similarly, this is also positive resistance. But this is part shows negative resistance. Because by increasing E, Z is decreases. As a result, the initially homogeneous sample becomes electrically heterogeneous. Electrically heterogeneous is an attempt to reach stability. In the voltage controlled negative resistance mode, high field domains are formed, separating two low field regions. Here, this point is very important to understand. Voltage controlled negative resistance mode, high field domains are formed. For voltage controlled negative resistance mode, high field domains are formed, separating the two field regions. It will be understood easily in next article, where we see how two different regions are considered using the variables. The interfaces separating low and high domains lie along equipotency. Interfaces which are separating low and high field domains are at equipotence. Thus, they are in planes perpendicular to the current direction. In the current controlled negative mode, splitting the sample results in high current filaments running along the field direction. You can see here, this is high field domain and this is high current filament. And in high field domain, you can see this is high field and this is low field. Okay? And in voltage controlled negative resistance mode, high field domains are formed, separating two field regions. One is low and one is high. The interface low and high field domains lie along the equipotence. Thus, they are in planes perpendicular to the current direction. The fields are perpendicular to current direction, and lie along equipotentials, low field and high. Second one is high current filament, and current is flowing in the same direction, and this is the field high current, and the remaining field, this field is low current. In current controlled negative resistance mode, splitting the simples results in high current filaments running along the field direction. Expressed mathematically, the negative resistance of the sample at a particular region, we know that negative resistance is given by Di upon dV, and this can be replaced I by J and V by E. So dJ upon dV and this is the method expressed mathematically the negative resistance of the sample at a particular region. Now if an electric field EG is applied to the sample, for example the current density J0 is 0. For E0, current density J0 is generated. As the applied field or voltage is increased to E2, if we increase the voltage to E2, what we see? We see that current density decreased. J2 versus E2. That means corresponding value of J2 to E2 is decreased with respect to E0, J0. When the field or voltage is decreased, that means E1 or V1, corresponding current density J1 increases. These phenomena of the voltage controlled negative resistance are shown in this field. Similarly, for the current controlled mode, what we see, if corresponding to E0, there is value J0, and we are seeing E2, corresponding value J2 is decreased. And similarly, if E1 is decreased, J1 is increased. So, we can understand how multi-values of current density for negative resistance from this paper by B.K. Riddle. B.K. Riddle's original paper, and these explanations are given is there in that research paper. Okay? So in next lecture, after understanding the negative resistance, we try to understand the two-valley model theory. That is very important for transferred electron devices. Thanks to all of you. Just try to understand these concepts. If you are able to understand the concepts and strength in the concepts in this field, then you can easily understand the theories and you can also remember these topics easily. Otherwise, these are very typical to remember. So, such kind of process must be necessary for you. Thanks to all of you.